everyone and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today in this tutorial we'll write a Python program to check whether entered number is positive or negative. So input for this program is nothing but a number. You can enter float number or integer number, and the output of this program is whether that number is positive, negative or zero. We need to find that. So then how to check the entered number is positive or negative? If the entered number is greater than 0, that means that number is positive. If that number is less than 0, then that means that number is negative. And if that number is 0, that means that is 0. 0 is neither positive nor negative. So we need to check whether the entered number is greater than 0. If yes, then that means that number is positive number. Entered number is positive number. Else we need to check whether that number is less than 0. If yes, then that means that number is negative number. If both the condition is false, that means that number is 0. Entered number is 0. So let's write the program. So in the Python file, first we need to take the input from the user, right? So for that I'll take a variable name as n, and here I'll take the input from the user using the input function, and here I'll write enter the number. So this message will display on the output screen, and here I'm using Python 3, and in Python 3 this input function will take input as string value, but here we want number, integer number or float number, right? So here I'll convert my input to integer. If you want, you can convert it to float also. Now we are done with the input. Next we need to check the entered number is positive or negative. So here first we need to check the number is positive. If yes, then we need to print a message that number is positive. If not, I need to check whether that number is less than 0. If that is true, that means that number is negative. If both the condition false, that means the entered number is 0. So we need to check 3 conditions, right? So to do this, I'll use if, elif and else condition. So I'll take first if condition and I'll check whether the entered number is greater than 0, whether n is greater than 0. Entered input will be stored in the variable n, so I'll check whether that is greater than 0. If s, so just print the entered number, that is n is positive number. So positive number, right? So next, if it is not, then I need to check whether n is less than 0, or you can check n is equal to 0 also, it's your wish. So here let's take elif condition. Elif stands for else and if. If n is less than 0, or you can take if n is equal to 0 also here, then you need to print if n is less than 0, that means n is negative number, right? If this condition is true, that means n is a negative number. Alright, if both this condition is false, if entered number is not greater than 0 or not less than 0, then that means the entered number is 0, right? So I'll take the else condition. No need to check for the condition here because we already know either the entered number can be greater than 0 or less than 0. If both are false, that means the entered number is 0. Here I'll print entered number is 0. Alright, so now we are done with the program, so we need to execute this. So I'll save this and execute this. Enter the number. So let's try 34. 34 is a positive number, right? It is greater than 0, that means it is a positive number. I'll enter minus 10. It is a negative number. If I enter 0, entered number is 0. Now if you want to take float value, here you can take float, and here enter number 3.4, it is a positive number, so minus 2.4, negative number, or you can take 0. So let's see how this program works. So the program execution begins from the first line, so it will ask the user to enter a number. For example, if I enter number as 3, right, that 3 will be stored in the variable n. If I use float function here, it will convert the entered input to float. So we'll get 3.0. If you use int function here, we'll get integer value, integer 3. That will be stored in the variable n. Next, it will check for the if condition. If n is greater than 0, here n value is 3. 3 is greater than 0. Yes, it is true. So it will print this message. N is a positive number. Because this condition is true, it won't check for the elif and else condition. So it won't check this. What is the purpose of if else conditional statement? It is to choose which part of the code need to be executed, right? Based on the condition. If the condition is true, it will execute this part. If this condition become false, for example, if I enter n as minus 4, so this condition become false, so it will go to the elif condition. Minus 4 is less than 0, it will check this condition. Yes, it becomes true, so it will print this message. If both this condition is false, for example, if I enter n as 0, 0 is not greater than 0, it fails, so it will check for the next condition. 0 is less than 0, no, it fails, so it will come to the else part and it will print this message. Both the condition fails, so it will print entered number is 0. Okay, so in this way this program works. So that's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.